the JAMA Network.
My name is Andy Menke. I'm an epidemiologist with Social and Scientific Systems. Previous studies have shown that the prevalence of diabetes has been increasing in the United States. The objective of this study was to estimate the recent prevalence in total diabetes, diagnosed diabetes, undiagnosed diabetes, and pre-diabetes in the U.S. We studied about 26,000 people participating in a series of nationally representative surveys of the United States population called the National Health and Nutrition Examination Surveys. The first one was conducted between 1988 and 1994, and the most recent one was conducted between 2011 and 2012. We found 14% of the people in the U.S. have diabetes, and this was even higher in Blacks, Asians, and Hispanics. Around a third of the total people with diabetes were undiagnosed, and this was increased up to 50% of Asians and Hispanics were not aware that they had the condition. And the entire United States population, about a third, have pre-diabetes, which means about 50% of people in the U.S. have either diabetes or pre-diabetes. Between the first survey in 88 and 94 to the last survey in 2011-2012, the prevalence increased about 25%, and it increased in every subgroup that we studied, in each age group, both sexes, and each race group. The prevalence of diabetes is high in the United States, and it's increasing. And it's even higher among Blacks, Asians, and Hispanics. Many of these cases are undiagnosed, around a third in the total population, and higher in Asians and Hispanics. Also, it's increasing over time. Future research should focus on subgroups of Asian Americans. This is particularly interesting since they had a relatively high prevalence of diabetes and a high prevalence of undiagnosed diabetes. This is interesting because the BMI of Asian Americans is actually lower than other race ethnic groups in the United States.